taxes, income tax, federal taxes, state taxes, city taxes, property taxes. When I tell you they tax you every single which way that they can, oh my gosh, it's ridiculous. But I'm here to tell you that there are 10 ways that you can actually save on taxes. So I'm going to share those tips with you right now. Hi, I'm Shana of The Wealth Vibe, and I create videos to help you eliminate debt, grow your income, and build wealth. We get taxed so much, and some people are fed up with it. But taxes do actually serve a purpose for the public good. And even if you do believe in some taxes, I'm sure you still believe in saving money on taxes. So I'm going to share with you the ways that you can save money on taxes this season. There are three main ways that you can save on taxes. That's through deferments, deductions, and credits. And I'm going to talk all about the various ways that you can capitalize on deferments, deductions, and credits to save you money. But the first way that I'm going to tell you to save money on your taxes actually has nothing to do with deductions, deferments, or credits. But it's definitely going to save you some money. So you'll want to adjust your withholdings. And the reason why this is important is if you are an employee, your employer typically withholds federal and state income taxes from your paycheck, meaning that your paycheck or your take-home pay is a lot less than your salary due to taxes. And what happens is that your employer pays the federal government taxes on your behalf, and then when you file your taxes the next year, the federal government will say, oh wait, you paid us a little bit too much money, so we're going to refund or return the money that you paid us. So if you get a tax refund when you file your taxes, that means most times that you are overpaying your taxes. So the reason why you want to adjust your withholdings is because the federal government is actually holding onto your money throughout the entire year, and they're giving it back to you interest-free. Interest-free. So that means that you are actually losing money. And you're losing money, one, because you have opportunity costs that occur because of the government holding onto your money. So that means that you can't actually do the things that you want to do because you actually have less money to work with throughout the year. And then the second way that you're losing money is because you could be using that money to put into the stock market or to put into a high yield interest account where you're able to make money on your money. So if you are overpaying on your taxes, you want to save money by adjusting your withholdings. The great thing is that if you have been overpaying on your taxes, you can actually change that up right now. So there is actually a federal calculator that you can use to determine the exact amount of money that you need to withhold from your paychecks in order to not overpay on your taxes. So I'm going to leave the link to that calculator down in the description box, but you definitely want to do this in order to save yourself money on your taxes. A common reason why some people do not contribute to their retirement accounts is because they feel like they'll have less money to work with now. But that could be far from the truth. So you'll want to contribute to your retirement accounts, one, to save money on taxes, but also to free up money in your regular paycheck. So the reason why it allows you to save on your taxes is because a lot of the times your retirement accounts that are employer sponsored, like the 401k or the 403b, are tax advantage accounts, meaning that they allow you to contribute money pre-tax, and that means that you save a lot more money by reducing the amount of money that is actually taxed. So for example, if you make $100,000, and you contribute $20,000 to your 401k every single year, that means that you'll only be taxed on $80,000. So that definitely saves you a lot of money. The additional benefit of contributing to pre-tax retirement accounts is that you free up more money for yourself later and now. So what happens typically is that your employer will match the amount of money that you contribute to your pre-tax retirement accounts. But also, since you're being taxed less on your income, you might actually bring home a little bit more money. So it's going to definitely benefit you if you do contribute to your pre-tax retirement accounts, because you're going to save money on taxes while also bringing in more money for yourself as well. Similar to your pre-tax retirement accounts, you can save money by contributing to medical savings accounts like your HSA and your FSA. And this saves you money because they're also pre-tax contributions. And sometimes your employers will also match the money that you contribute to your HSA and FSA. And the really cool thing is that your HSA is actually one of the best tax advantage accounts out there because you can get triple tax savings. So you definitely want to look into contributing to your medical savings accounts. And they'll also save you a lot of money on your medical treatments because you're able to pay really at a discount because you're paying for your medical treatments with pre-tax money, meaning that you're saving maybe 20, 25%, maybe even 30% on your medical treatments just by putting money into your HSA and FSAs and using that money to pay for your medical treatments. So that is another way to save money on your taxes. Earlier, I told you that deductions is the way that you can save on your taxes. And I've already covered two types of deductions, such as your pre-tax retirement accounts and your medical savings accounts that will allow you to reduce your taxable income. But there are other deductions that you can utilize as well. So there are standard deductions and itemized deductions. And due to changes in the tax law, most of us will have more advantage when taking the standard deduction. But then if you have a lot more expenses that are beyond the standard deduction, you might want to consider itemized deductions. So what that means is that you'll have a whole lot of expenses that exceed the limit for deductions of the year. So you'll want to have tracking of how much you've spent on certain expenses. Everyday expenses, you want to have all of that laid out. There are other deductions that you can take advantage of if they apply to your specific situation. For example, you can deduct medical expenses, business-related expenses, or even student loan interest payments. So you can deduct up to $2,500 on the interest that you pay towards your student loans. You can also have partial deductions for your mortgage and property tax as well. So you'll want to look into all the deductions that apply to your specific situations and figure out ways that you can reduce your taxable income through deductions. Did you know that you can actually save money on your taxes by saving money towards education expenses? So if you contribute money to a 529 plan, which is used to pay for college or university, or even sometimes elementary, middle, and high school for private institutions or religious institutions, you can actually put aside money in a 529 plan for the purposes of saving for those education costs. But as a result, that will save you money on taxes. So you definitely want to look into that if it applies to your situation. We haven't talked about credits yet as a way to save on your taxes, but there are two common credits that usually people can apply to their taxes to save. So the first kind is the Earned Income Tax Credit, and you can get that if you haven't made a lot of money. So the government will actually give you a credit to supplement the amount of income that you aren't making if you are a low to moderate wage earner. And then there's also the education tax credit. So if you've been in school, and depending on how much you paid towards school, how you paid, and your adjusted gross income, you can actually get a credit towards the amount of money that you spent on school, which will reduce the amount of money that you spent on taxes because the government will actually give you back money. That's how credits work. You're actually getting money because you meet certain stipulations and criteria. So those are two common credits that might actually apply for you and allow you to save on your taxes. I want to reiterate another way that you can save on your taxes, which is by paying your student loans, because this is often overlooked. People don't realize that you can actually get up to $2,500 deducted from your taxes just by paying your student loan, which you're gonna have to do anyway to be in good financial standing. And so you definitely want to look out for the forms that your service provider sends you so that you can file that with your taxes and claim your deduction. Get some money back at least, right? This might seem like a simple one, but it will definitely save you money on your taxes. Pay your taxes on time. If you are self-employed or you have a business or you're a freelancer, you typically have to pay your taxes on a quarterly basis, AKA quarterlies. And you wanna make sure that you are doing that to ensure that you aren't falling behind with paying your taxes and end up with a huge tax bill at the end of the year that you're surprised by and also can't afford. So make sure that you are paying your taxes on a quarterly basis or at least by the end of the year. And if you want to learn some of my strategies for how to stash away money for your taxes so that way you don't fall behind, check out this video right here. And also, people who are employed, you want to listen to this one too. You want to pay your taxes on time. So typically the filing date and the time for you to pay your taxes is usually by April 15th. So if you have not paid enough taxes, either because your taxes were not withheld at all or too little taxes were withheld from your paycheck, you typically have to pay money for your taxes. And you wanna make sure that is done by the filing due date of April 15th of every year. And if you can't do that, you wanna file for an extension because it'll avoid you having to pay additional fees, taxes, or additional fees, interest, and penalties. So make sure that you pay on time. This one might not be applicable to most people, but did you know that there are certain states that do not pay income taxes? So if you live in a state that borders a no income tax state, you might want to consider moving. Yes, it will have implications for your commute time, for your school districts and things like that, but it can save you thousands of dollars every single year on taxes. For example, if your state income tax is 7% and you make $100,000, you can save $7,000 just by moving across the border to a no income tax state. So highly consider that if it's possible for you, because you could be saving yourself a lot of money. I told you a lot of different ways that you can save on your taxes for the current year taxes. But did you know that you could actually save on your taxes by reviewing the taxes that you filed in the past? You actually have up to 3 years to adjust your taxes from previous years. Because let's say you're doing your taxes for this year and you realize, you know what, I actually didn't include this expense on my taxes, or I didn't include this or that or whatever else. You can actually file an amendment for previous tax years, up to 3 years, so that you can recoup the money that you paid in taxes in those previous years. Although you might be frustrated with paying taxes, I just told you 10 different ways that you can save on taxes. But if you need any additional help with taxes, you want to check out this playlist right here. I have several videos that cover how to file for taxes, how to stash away money to save for your taxes, and everything. So check it out. And I hope that you are subscribed so that I can see you on the next video.